Do you love living on a small island?
Yes, I do.
What's up, guys? We are Vagabond Academy, and we've been living on this small island of Shaolocho for about a year now, and we absolutely love it.
And today, we're going to go through a few reasons why we love living on this small island.
But before that, we're going to take a short ride to one of our favorite places on this island.
Do you know that in Taiwan, we drive on the right-hand side?
Do you have a driver's license?
No.
Do you have a scooter license?
No.
Do you have a motorcycle license?
No.
Well, I have a driver's license, a motorcycle license, and a scooter license. And I've been driving for almost as long as you've been alive, so you should say nothing! This is a great place to hang out all day, but particularly during the sunset. It doesn't face directly west, but you can get a peek of it just right over there. So one of the most surprising things I didn't realize that I quite like about living on a small island is that you have a lack of choice. And everywhere I lived, it's been quite an urban setting. Berkeley, Shanghai, Hong Kong, Taipei, Las Vegas, and there's so much choice. Let's say, for example, in terms of eating at restaurants that have Mexican, hamburgers, French food, Spanish food, Japanese food, Korean food, Thai food, whatever. Especially steak. Not so much choice in Shaolocho.
I love it. Because I don't like to choose stuff. I just want like one or two and that's it.
It goes with having a simpler life. And definitely our life is much simpler here. And as a result, a lot less stressful. Something called the paradox of choice. Having a lot of choice is not necessarily a good thing. Having a couple choices, yeah, that's great. But when you have too much choices, you're kind of like analysis by paralysis. You can't choose. You're stressed out about the choice. And then you worry about whether your choice is the best choice or not. And when you have too many choices, you'll never be satisfied. We eat at maybe 3 places on a consistent basis.
And the second thing we love living on this small island is because people are nicer and
like chocolate.
Yeah, hi.
I'm going
to the sunset. Bye-bye.
She went to go see the sunset.
Okay, we will take out the shop now.
So why I think people are nicer on a small island, first off, people are happier here. There's a lot of reasons for that. But having a small community, when you live in a small community, you really can't afford to be an asshole because everybody know you're an asshole. If I'm in a big city like Hong Kong, Taipei, wherever, and I'm an asshole, everyone will know about it. Part of the reason you live in a big city, just to get to anywhere, takes a long time, at least half an hour, sometimes an hour. From our house to here, is possibly the longest scooter ride we'll do on the island. It took less than 10 minutes to get here. Most places are under 5 minutes, and so there isn't a significant chunk of our day taken by transporting ourselves to and from wherever. I mean, I did a couple of errands. I went to the doctor, I filled up my gas tank, I had my scooter repaired, and I went to the 7-Eleven to print some stuff out, then I went to the stationery store. That took up like an hour.
# island life.
There's no traffic lights on this island. Remember we're in Gilliard? There is no scooters, no cars, just bicycles, walking.
And horses.
Yeah. Yeah, so obviously being on a small island, we're near the ocean. And I love the ocean. You love the ocean? What do you feel? How you feel when you get in the ocean?
Everything released.
I read this book called The Blue Mind, and it was using neuroscience to prove that being in or around water or ocean is good for your mental health and physical health. As soon as you get in the water, your body starts lowering cortisol, which is the stress hormone. It also moves your brain from to a more relaxed brainwave like theta or alpha, and so you basically instantly relax when you get in the water. And I get a lot of release, I guess, from life. And whenever we go into the city like Kaohsiung or Taipei, we come back, we immediately just drop our stuff at our place, go straight to the beach, even if it's just rubbing our feet into the wet sand, we feel a lot lighter. But also, when we're on the island here, we do work very long hours behind the computer sometimes when I'm not teaching freediving. And it's really nice to be able to break up the day. You know, I work in the morning, then the afternoon, go for a swim in the ocean, and then that kind of revives me to work for the rest of the afternoon. So one of the reasons why we like coming to high jumping or ocean looking ice is you can see the sunset. Now it doesn't look directly west, but off in the corner you can see it setting, and it's still quite beautiful. So I do love seeing the sunsets almost every day. Sunrise sometimes when I wake up really early and I get motivated, I'll sometimes do breathing exercises or meditation by the beach. Sheila never has seen the sunrise. She doesn't know what it is. Doesn't know what it looks like. Your alarm goes off at 7:30, and then you snooze, and then you snooze for like an hour and a half to 2, 3, 4.
If you like this video, hit the like and subscribe button below. Tell us what you want to see next from us.